important point. Okay, so, and you see, like, most often it's these tea shops besides the road, and these are cups, leaves, plastic bags, bottles, all these things, right? So I'm targeting this kind of garbage, and how do I lift it up? Is using this design. This is my initial prototypes. You've seen Roomba, right? How Roomba cleans the room, it's through vacuum. It consumes a lot of power. It's not designed for roads, but it can only work on smooth surfaces. But this one, it can actually pick up from roads. The garbage goes from inside these two brushes, and due to clockwise, anti-clockwise, it lifts up garbage, collects in the tray. Over the time, I saw some limitations. There was the tray size is small. It was not very navigable to the potholes. So I made some design increments, added extra wheels, added extra tray. And then right now, I'm here. I chose to go with solar power because with battery, first the battery's weight is too much. Lead acid cell batteries are very heavy. It limits the range. But with solar, I can, like, till there's sun over my head, I can go anywhere. It can do a lot of more work. It can work for hours and hours. And other things which I've tried to incorporate is, I've tried to make it as autonomous as possible. I've tried to, from what I could do on object tracking, OpenCV filters, make it identify the garbage, whether it is recyclable, non-recyclable, wet, dry. And you can also do surveillance. So for example, if you are taking pictures of somebody throwing garbage every day, I think after 4 days, it's fair to, bond that person or at least file a case on him that he's being a defaulter every day. So this is a basic design. And okay, yeah, there's a camera there. So this is a basic design, and right, so this basically has RPI and Arduino to control some motors and some brushes. If you are interested in this, but due to paucity of time, I'll skip this. It is taking me about 5-6 years to incrementally build and modify and customize. So we'll see the demo at the right now. So the brushes are not working right now, but short demo first. So in action, it looks like here you can see close up how it lifts up. So this is cups, papers, leaves, wrappers, milk wrappers. You can also lift up cigarette butts and things like that. And I'm trying to work on object identification, but you know, it's very difficult to identify leaves and plastic wrappers because they don't have any definite shape. So I'm looking at other ways in which I can better identify things. If you have feedback suggestion, please do write to me if you have a better way of doing this. And yeah, that's about it. Any questions? Thank you. Any questions?
What's the stack that you're using for building this?
So everything's on GitHub though. I'm using Python code on Arduino and Raspberry Pi to Python code with OpenCV filters to detect garbage, and the web console which I'm using to control is on native JavaScript. There's not much there. Flask as the backend, and some challenges I would like to share. So right now with this solar battery that I got from SP Road after a lot of struggles, this is very heavy. And it is only 50 watts. So I'm looking at better solar panels that will increase, my flexibility, also the weight constraint. So the solar power is very limited. It's a very feeble amount of energy that I can accumulate. So there's not much weight I can put on the robot. So every small component I add, I have to measure its weight. So the overall weight of the robot should not exceed 5 kgs at all. Otherwise, the wheels will completely give up and it will stop working. And I have to keep buffer for the garbage. So these are my biggest challenges. And some roadmaps are that I wanted to integrate with ROS software and have a 3D model of the roads that it has covered so that it doesn't go over the same road again and again. And to make it idiot proof, because I want it to be autonomous. I don't want people kicking it. If somebody is kicking it, at least it should capture a photo of the person who's kicked it. And sensors for e-waste. There's a lot of electronic waste which is 100% recyclable, and it's our duty to segregate it, and it is our duty as a software engineer to, because it's related to our field, to enable its recycling. And there's some stats that I'm trying to collect based on object identification, what kind of garbage it has picked, what kind of colonies we targeted, what colonies are producing more garbage.